everyone, it's Miss Carol, and it's story time again. And this week I chose to read from our superheroes storybook again. I know I read it last week, I read about a few superheroes, but I think this is a great book to read from. So I wanted to read another superhero. I know we read about Noah and Joseph. So this week I thought I would read about superhero Moses, a strong leader. Many years later, the Israelites became slaves in Egypt. It wasn't fun. The Egyptians were mean. The Israelites begged God to rescue them, and he answered their prayers. He sent Moses. "Lead my people out of Egypt, Moses. I don't want them to be slaves anymore," God said. Oh, Moses was nervous. He wasn't sure he could do it, but God promised to help him. God sent 10 terrible plagues on the Egyptians. After each one, Moses went to the Pharaoh of Egypt and said, "God says to let his people go." 9 times Pharaoh said, "Nope." Finally, after the 10th plague, Pharaoh let the Israelites leave, and Moses led the people out of Egypt. One night, they set up camp on the shore of the Red Sea. But then they saw Pharaoh's army coming after them. He had changed his mind. He wanted his slaves back in Egypt. There was no way to escape. The Red Sea was behind them, and the Egyptian army was in front of them. "Why did you lead us out of Egypt? Now Pharaoh will make us work harder than ever." Oh, the people complained to Moses, but Moses wasn't scared. "Don't be afraid. Watch what God does," he said. He held his shepherd's staff over the water of the Red Sea. God sent a strong wind blowing across the water. Pretty soon, the water blew into 2 big walls with dry ground between them. God held the water back while every single Israelite crossed through the sea safely. The Egyptians tried to follow, but God let the waters crash down on them, and the Israelite people were safe. Superhero Moses. Superhero characteristic. Moses was a strong and fearless leader. He led the Israelites out of Egypt. Even when he wasn't sure what to do, he trusted God to help him. Superhero tip. God asked Moses to lead the people. He gave him the courage and the power to do the job. When God gives you a job to do, he'll give you the power to do it as well. You know, boys and girls, I think I read this one last week. It seems so familiar. Well, if I did, he's such a good superhero. So I was looking at one I know I haven't read yet. Superhero Samuel, supersonic hearing. Samuel was just a young boy when he went to live in the temple so that Eli the priest could teach him how to serve God. One night, Samuel was in bed when he heard someone call his name. "Samuel!" He jumped out of bed and ran to see what Eli wanted, but Eli was asleep. It wasn't Eli who had called. So Samuel went back to bed. He was nearly asleep when he heard his name called again. "Samuel! Samuel!" Right away, the young boy jumped out of bed and ran to Eli again. He asked what he could do for the old priest. But once again, Eli said, "Go back to bed. I did not call you." Well, Samuel was a little confused. He knew he was hearing his name called, and if it wasn't Eli calling him, then who was it? Samuel climbed back into his bed and pulled his blanket up. It took a while for him to fall asleep because he kept wondering who was calling his name. Just as he was dozing off, Samuel heard the voice again. "Samuel! Samuel!" So for the third time, Samuel leaped out of his bed and ran to Eli. "What do you need, sir?" he asked. At last, Eli knew what was going on. "Samuel, It is God calling you. Here's what you do. Go back to bed, and when God calls again, say this, "Here I am." Samuel did just what Eli said, and God told him amazing things. Superhero characteristic. Samuel had super good hearing. He heard God calling him and listened to what he said. A superhero listens carefully and then acts. Superhero tip. It is important to make time to be quiet so you can listen. It's hard to hear God's voice speaking if you don't get quiet first. When you pray, ask God to help you to listen to what He wants to tell you. That's a good one, huh, boys and girls? Be quiet so that you can hear what God is saying to you. I think we did Superhero David last time. I want to do one more. I just love this superhero book. I should mark these, boys and girls, so I know which ones I read because I wanted to read all of them. Here's one. This will be the last one. Superhero hero Elijah. Fire from heaven. Elijah obeyed and served God at a time when not many other people did. In fact, King Ahab and lots of other people served fake gods like Baal. Things weren't going so well in Israel, and King Ahab accused Elijah of causing trouble for everyone who didn't follow God. So Elijah decided it was time to take a stand and make people decide if the fake gods were real or if God was real. This is how he did it. He challenged all the priests who followed the fake god Baal to a contest. "Meet me on Mount Carmel. You build an altar and dig a trench around it. Then cut up a bull and put it on the altar, but do not set fire to it. Call for your god Baal to send down fire and burn up the offering. Then I will do the same and call on God to burn up the offering." Baal's priest did what Elijah said. They shouted and called and begged for Baal to send fire, but no fire came. They shouted some more. Elijah watched and he said, "Maybe Baal is in the bathroom. Shout leader." They did, but no fire came. Finally, Elijah said, "Okay, it's my turn." He built an altar and put the bull on it, but he wasn't finished. He wanted to show how very powerful God is. So he poured lots and lots of water over the altar. Then he called on God to send fire and burn up the offering. God sent fire immediately. He sent such a powerful fire that it burned up the offering and all the water around it. It burned everything. The prophets of Baal saw the power of the one true God. Superhero characteristic. Elijah challenged the priest to a contest to see how great their gods were. Elijah won the contest hands down because, of course, only he served the true and living God who could send down fire from heaven. He wasn't scared of losing against their false gods. Superhero tip. Taking a stand for God gives others a chance to see his awesome power. When you serve the one true God, you don't have to be afraid of anyone else. That's a good one, huh, boys and girls? What a superhero he was. So we read about a few superheroes today. Next week, we'll read a few more. Well, boys and girls, have a great week. And as I always say to you, God loves you every second, every minute, every hour of every day. That never changes. So until the next time we meet, blessings to you all. I miss you. Have a great week. Bye.